Hey, what's up guys, Nunu here. In this video, I'll show you a step-by-step tutorial of an exterior render and surrounding environment in Lumion. If you want to get more videos like this from me, subscribe and hit the bell button to get notified when I publish my new videos.
So I'll start by importing the model, and then here I'm just trying to get the best position for this scene. Now I'll go to the render settings, and here I'll choose the realistic style effect as a starting point. I'll disable the chromatic aberrations and depth of field because I don't want those to get in the way for now. And I'll add the effect called 2-point perspective. So this effect will straighten out your lines. Then I'll adjust the camera focal length, and between 20 to 24 it's okay, so we don't have too much distortion. When I start moving a little bit to the back, you can see that the wall is starting to block my view. To fix this, I will actually put a near clip plane effect, and this will change the minimum distance at which objects are drawn. I don't have the wall anymore blocking. I'll just do a quick render to test how the scene is looking. Alright. Now I'm starting to add some materials to this scene.
I'll use materials that are included mostly on the Lumion library.
And here, I'll just adjust the edge property, because all the surfaces that you find in the world, none of them has super sharp edges. So this effect in the shader is quite useful, so you don't have to model all of this geometry, so you can just adjust a little bit to your taste, and it will look much better. And also I'll add a little bit of weathering as well. Now I'll just fast forward a little bit because I'll be adjusting most of the materials on this scene. As you can see here, I don't have anything modeled inside. So to hide this, I'll just add from my library some curtains, and it will still look visually appealing, and it will also hide that I don't have any interiors. I'll make another test render. And now to make this scene more interesting, I'll start adding some trees, some vegetation, all of these elements to start making the scene come together. I'll continue to add some elements that I'll think that will fit this scene. I will add some trees to the background. I'll use these cluster ones because they are very fast to render, and from far you'll notice that there are some image projection of these trees. Now I'll add some trees to the background so they can mix up a little bit with the sky and make the image visually more appealing. So I'll add a couple of those in front of the house as well, because I want to have some nice shadows. Okay, let's just test this. Okay, it's looking good. But I don't like some of the vegetation position that I got here, so I'll start moving around some things. I'll add some decoration pieces to the front of the window. I'll also add a reflection probe, so I'll be able to cast proper reflections on this side, since it's the side I'm going to render this scene. I'll add a couple of lights as well. I will adjust a little bit the brightness and the cone angle. And I'll start by adding a little bit of sharpen, and I'll add the real skies, and these real skies allow us to have HDRI inside Lumion, so I'll just select the one that fits best for me in this scene. I'll try to have something that can cast some shadows in front of the house. I'm still trying here to figure out which one is best. Okay, this one looks great. Let's render it. Now I'm going to switch this 2D grass material, because initially I had this one like this to be faster to render when I'm still testing, but now that I am sure, I'll just add a 3D grass, which looks much better. Now I'm going to replace some of the vegetation and trees that I have, because I didn't like them so much, so I'll just fast forward this part. Okay, I'm happy with the settings of this 3D grass. Now I'll keep adjusting some of the elements in my scene. I'll keep adjusting some of the effects, and I'll add some fog. Fog is great for this type of scenes because it creates some depth between your subject and the background. So I'll play around with the settings of the fog, with the density and with the fall off. I'll add some greenish tint to it because we have a lot of forest here. So you can see here how it creates already some separation between the background and the foreground. I'll also add here a volumetric sunlight effect. This effect is basically God rays, and it allows you to have a beam of light shining through the environment, and this can give a really nice effect of three-dimensional, especially when it passes through fog, dust, smoke, etc. I'll now adjust parameters, for example skylight. I'll put the first slider to the maximum and everything to ultra. I'll just decrease a little bit the hyperlight effect. Change a little bit on the color correction, the limit low, because it will give me a little bit darker shadows. Okay, as for the reflection effect, I'll start editing all the reflection planes, and these reflection planes basically are telling the render which surfaces you want to be the highest quality in terms of reflections. So just here, usually you just have to take your time and select what you think is best and where you want the best quality of reflections. In the shadow parameter, I will adjust some settings, especially the coloring. I reduce a little bit the coloring. And in terms of omni shadow is basically ambient occlusion effect. So I'll increase a little bit as well. and I'll leave all the other settings as it is. For the chromatic aberrations, I usually just put all to the maximum, the first slider, and then I decrease the affected area just so it affects a little bit around the edges. Because I noticed that many renders in Lumion come with effect all over the scene, which looks really unnatural. Now I'll just be sure that I have on my reflection set to high, and then I'll render with output of specular, lighting and material ID as well, and I'll render this in 4K. And now let's wait. Okay, now let's start the post-processing of our scene in Photoshop. So now in Photoshop, I add all the maps and I duplicate with Ctrl J this layer, and I'll go to Camera Raw Filter. I like to go to Camera Raw Filter because it gives me more options in terms of exposure, saturation, highlights, and I always look into the histogram because I don't want to go overexposed or underexposed, so it's always good to keep a look on this. So here I'm just trying to get the best settings for my scene. I just play around with the clarity, with the saturation, with the temperature to try to get the colors the way I want. I also add a little bit of vignetting to this scene and it's good to go. Now I'll add the specular output. And on this layer, I'll change it to screen and I'll put it at about 40% the fill, so it pushes a little bit the reflections. I'll also get the ambient occlusion, which is called lighting in Lumion, and I'll change it to multiply, and I will create a new layer mask and I'll start masking just the areas that I want this mask to be affected. So basically, I'm just adding a little bit more contrast in this grass, in the vegetation. I also get the material ID because I want just to select the sky, and I'll just add it a little bit. Now I'll start adding some color correcting filters, for example color balance, to get some tint to my shadows, to my highlights. I'll add the typical S curve. And I'll also play around a little bit with the saturation. I wanted to increase a little bit more the volumetric light effect. So to do this, I'll add a new gradient. And on this gradient, I'll put it from left to right. And I'll change the color to a yellowish orange tones. And I will just create a mask so it doesn't affect so much on the scene, and I'll change the opacity a little bit as well. I want to have some contrast on the other side, so I'll create the same effect but from right to left, and here I'll put a little bit of a bluish tint.
If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe and hit the bell button to get notified when I publish my new videos. And by the way, if you'd like to get this scene with a preset file, I'll share a link in the description below this video. See you in the next ones!